Good afternoon. This is Dr. Vineet Chauhan from School of Management, Sarvadharma Samhari University. Today, our topic is Overview of Income Tax of India. Under this topic, we will check it out the Income Tax Act, its components. Thereafter, we will check it out the concept of total income. We will go ahead of calculating the various and showing it to you the various rates of taxes, and later on, before conclusion, I will show it to you some practical example by which we can calculate the tax for an individual. Let us start with the components of Income Tax Act. The component which is in the Income Tax of India is made with the five different parts. The first part is itself is the Income Tax Act 1961. The Income Tax Act 1961 is applicable from 1st April 1962. This act has 298 sections and 14 schedules. Under these schedules, all the detail regarding the assessment procedure is being given. The second heading which is included in this is the Finance Act. The Finance Act is the act which will show it to us the rates of tax for a particular period or for a particular assessment year. In the Finance Act, the rates of tax are being prescribed and the taxation is being made on the basis of the rates which is prescribed in Finance Act. The third point is Income Tax Rule. Income Tax Rule is being made by the Central Board of Direct Tax Commissioner, CBDT Commissioner, who will make the rule from the CBDT office for the purpose of implementing it as per the Income Tax Act. Next portion is related with the circular and notification. In case if there is any problem in calculating the tax, in that case, the Income Tax Commissioner of CBDT will issue the certain issue a circular which is related to the certain problems and the expected solution, the path by which the problems can be sorted. Similarly, if any provision which has not been applicable and he wants to make it applicable for a particular date, the notifications are being issued. The last portion of the components includes case law. The case law is the judiciary system which is prevailing in India. It is based upon that judiciary system under which the Supreme Court is the apex body. Time to time there are various cases which has been in the court. Now the judgment of those cases are also included. In case the judgment is being given, that judgment is included in the case law and will be the base for the application. As per these components, the taxation in India is being done. Now we will go ahead and we will be checking it out that how the tax is being implemented on a particular person or on an assessee. In the taxation language, we always speak it out as assessee. Assessee means the person on which the income tax is due or on which the income tax is being due which is not being paid. The assessee includes all the type of assessee. It includes individual, association of person, Hindu undivided family, body of individual and company. As per the nature of the assessee, the tax rate is being given under the Finance Act which has been implemented. The second thing which is important, that is the assessment procedure. The procedure by which the tax is being calculated is included in the assessment procedure. Before we go to the concept of total income, we should check it out the tax implementation time period. The tax is implemented or the tax is levied on the basis of the previous year and assessment year concept. If I write it here, assessment year. First, assessment year is the year in which we assess the income of an individual person which is being taken for the previous year. The assessment year will show the assessment year in any case will starts always from the 1st of April and it ends on 31st March next year. The current assessment year is 1st April 2015 and it ends on 31st March 2016. Which means that in this period, the tax is levied on the income of the previous year, which has been already earned by the assessor. So the second part which we have to see, that is the previous year. Previous year is the period in which the assessee has earned the income which is due for the tax. And that period is also just preceding to this assessment year period, which means that the previous year is 1st April 2014 to 31st March 2015. The income of that particular year is being taxed in the current year. Now, how the income will be taxed for that purpose, we need to check it out the concept of total income. On the basis of concept of total income, the tax is being calculated, and for that purpose, we need to assess the individual's income. That income is assessed on this basis. For that purpose, there are total 6 steps which may be followed. If you check it out with the step number 1, the step number 1 is related with the determination of the residential status of an assessee. The residential status of an assessee will be either resident, non-ordinary resident and non-resident. On the basis of these 3 status of an individual, the tax is being levied. This 3 classification is for an individual and Hindu undivided family. For rest of the assessee like companies and partnership, there will be only 2 types of residential status, resident or non-resident. After the determination of residential status, we will go ahead and we will checking it out the heads of the income for any assessee. Our assessee will get income from any source, but for the purpose of Income Tax Act, it is divided into 5 parts. Income from salary, income from house property, income from business and profession, income from capital gain, and finally income from other sources. The income of an assessee which has been earned by the way of his salary is called income from salary. For this purpose, a separate portion of calculation will be included in the assessment procedure by which we assess the income from salary. Similarly, for other heads, the different part or the different forms are available for filling the income tax return. Similarly, the income from house property is assessed in the second head of income. Income from business or the profession is assessed in the third part. Income from capital gain of an assessee is assessed in the fourth head of income. And if any income which lies with the assessee, which is liable to the tax, that will also be included in income from other sources. Now, once we identified the residential status of an assessee, we identified the income of an assessee as per the 5 heads. Thereafter, we have to add the total income of an assessee by adding these 5 heads income. Once we add the income, thereafter we will go towards the step number 3. The step number 3 is exempt income. The income which is included in any of the 5 heads but which is not taxable, that will be reduced from this, and that is why it is called the exempt income. Once we reduce the exempt income, thereafter we will go to the next step, that is step number 4, which is clubbing of income. Sometime assessee, for the purpose of reducing its tax, transfer either its assets or transfer the income from the assets to somebody else. For that purpose, there are various laws in Income Tax Act which says that if assessee will transfer its income to either its spouse or transfer to their children, transfer to their grandson, in that case, the income tax authority will check it out and the clubbing of income will be made. For example, if a minor child is in the family and minor child is earning an income, then out of that income, ₹1,500 deduction is allowed, and the remaining income will be added in the income of his father or mother. And by adding, the income tax authority will also check that the income which is more for the father, then it will be added in the income of father. If the income is Income of mother is more, then it will be added in the income of mother. So the clubbing of income will be made. After the clubbing of income, we will go to the step fifth. In the step fifth, in case the assessee has suffered a loss in the previous year or in the current year, that will be reduced from the income which we have calculated in the step number 4. Suppose an assessee has paid the interest on house property, and that interest on house property is more than assessee's other income, or assessee's income on the income from house property, then that income will also be reduced from any other heads of income. Not only that, if assessee has total income in the previous year which is loss or which is a negative income, that negative income will also be reduced from the current year income, and that reducing of the income is called set off of the losses. Similarly, if all the losses are not being set off, they will be carried forward for the next year. That is why this fifth step is included, set off and carry forward of the losses. Once the set off and carry forward procedure is being made, thereafter we will go to the next step, which is called the gross total income or GTI of an assessee. Gross total income is the income which is the basic income of an assessee, out of which there are some deductions which are allowed for the purpose of various payments which is made by the assessee. For example, an assessee has made the provident fund contribution, or the assessee has made a provision for his medical insurance, or there are various other deductions which is allowed under Chapter 6A. Those are the deductions which is allowed. Once the deductions are reduced, then the assessee's net taxable income will be calculated. On that net taxable income, the tax is being calculated. So these are the seven steps by which the assessee's net taxable income is calculated. Once the assessee's net taxable income is calculated, thereafter we will go ahead for calculation of tax. The tax of an assessee is calculated with various rates which are prescribed in Income Tax Act. As per the current assessment year 2015-16, the previous year's income which will be assessed this year is on the basis of these rates which have been mentioned here. The rates are classified on the basis of the types of assessee and assessee's age. For example, first I have taken the individual assessee or a person. If an individual assessee who will earn an income in the previous year, that is from the period of 1st April 2014 to 31st March 2015, in that case, the assessee will be taxed as under. First, we will check it out the age of the assessee. If the assessee's age is below 60 years, means 0 to 60 years, in that case, these are the rates which will be applicable. The rates are on the basis of assessee's income, range and the rate of tax. For example, the assessee's income, net taxable income, is in between 0 to 250,000. The tax at the rate of nil is being applicable, which means that if assessee will earn less than 250,000 rupees, the tax will not be payable by the assessee. But if the assessee's income will increase and it is in between 250,000 to 5 lakh rupees, the 10% is the rate by which the tax is being calculated. Similarly, if assessee's income is more and it is in between 5 lakh to 10 lakh rupees, 20% will be the rate of tax. And if the assessee has earned more than 10 lakh rupees, the amount which is more than 10 lakh will be taxed at the rate of 30%. If in case the assessee will turn to be 60 year old in the previous year, that means he will turn to be a senior citizen, and between the age of 60 to 80 years, then the rate of tax has changed and he will get an additional benefit in the way that his income from 0 to 3 lakh will be taxed as nil. 3 to 5 lakh, the rate of tax will be 10%. 5 lakh to 10 lakh, the rate of tax will be 20%. And if that assessee has earned more than 10 lakh rupees, the rate of tax will also remain same, 30%. In case the assessment turns to be super senior citizen, means he crossed the age of 80 years in the previous year, in that case the tax rate will also, he will get also get the benefit, and the tax rate will be as under 0 to 5 lakh rupees of his income. He won't have to pay any tax because the rate of tax is nil. If the assessee's income is from 5 lakh to 10 lakh rupees, 20% will be the rate of tax, and if his income exceed 10 lakh rupees, 30% will be the rate of income tax, which is over the 10 lakh rupees. And including this, there are some other portion which is also included, other rates which are also included in the Income Tax Act, like for all the SSCs. Surcharge will be applicable if for an individual for which we have calculated this, the surcharge will be applicable if his income exceeds 1 crore of rupees. If an individual SSC's income exceeds 1 crore rupees, he has to pay 10% surcharge. If the income is less than 1 crore of rupees, he won't have to pay the surcharge. But in case surcharge is paid or not, the assessee has to pay two different taxes, two different sets on the income tax amount, which is calculated with the help of these three rates. So the education sets is payable at the rate of 2%, and the higher education sets is payable at the rate of 3%. So total 3% will be the sales amount which is payable by an assessee. So these are the rates on the, by which an individual will pay the tax to the government. There are certain fixed other rates of tax which is also applicable for an assessee. For example, if an assessee has earned income from long-term capital gain, that income is payable at the rate of 20%, straightforward rate without any exemption. If the same SSC has earned income by the way of short-term capital gain, which is on the sale of the shares and securities, in that case, the rate of tax will be 15%. Similarly, if an SSC will earn from a casual income, like by the way of winning the lottery, crossword puzzle, horse race, etc. In that case, the rate of tax will be 30% straight away, and that will be excluding this. So on these specified income, the specified rate of tax will be applicable, and after the rate of individual which has been applicable, in case of a company, the rate of tax will be different. So after checking it out, the rate of tax on individual, we will be checking it out the specific rate which is also mentioned in the Income Tax Act. For example, if an SSC will get an income on the basis of its long-term capital gain, the straightforward 20% is the rate of tax which will be applicable on that SSC. If the SSC will gain the income by the way of short-term capital gain on the equity shares which is being sold in the market, then straightforward 15% rate of tax will be applicable, but with the condition that security transaction tax is being payable. And if the assessee will get a casual income, the casual income means the income which is earned casually, which is not the regular income, and which is earned due to luck by chance, not due to the assessee's work. For example, income from lottery, income from crossword puzzle, income from horses, etc. is included in this, and the straightforward rate of 30% is applicable for the SSC. Now, after checking it out the individual SSC, we will go ahead and check it out the different SSCs. Like for the partnership firm, the income which is earned by partnership firm is taxed at the rate of 30%, which includes the limited liability partnership firm. So if a partnership firm or a limited liability partnership firm earns anything, that amount is taxable at the rate of 30% with the straightforward rate. Similarly, for local authority, the rate of tax is also 30%. For cooperative society, again, there are three different rates which are applicable. income is in between 0 to 10,000, they will have to pay the tax at the rate of 10%. If income exceeds 10,000 and it is between 10,000 to 20,000, the tax is payable at the rate of 20%. If the income is about 20,000, the tax is payable at the rate of 30%. For an Indian company, tax rate is 30%, which is also subject to surcharge. And the secondary and higher education says the surcharge is applicable on Indian company, which is by the two rates. That is, if your income is in between 1 crore to 10 crore, the rate of surcharge will be 5%. If the income of an Indian company is above 10 crore rupees, the rate of surcharge is 10%. If we check it out, the foreign company has to pay tax at the rate of 40% on state rate, and the surcharge which is applicable on foreign company too, that is from 1 to 10 crore rupees, they have to pay 2%. Above 10 crore rupees, they have to pay only 5%. So this is the rate of surcharge for Indian company and foreign company. And with this surcharge and with these rates of tax, each and every SSC has to pay 3% education cess and higher education cess. Not only that, the Income Tax Act has given the provision, that is for the low income group, that if an individual, only the individual SSC, has earned income below 5 lakh rupees, this is the net taxable income which is below 5 lakh, and if it is below 5 lakh, then they will get a rebate of 2000 from his tax payable. So we will first calculate his tax payable and later on we reduce 2000 rupees from his income. So this is the overall tax structure by which the tax is being calculated for any SSC. Now let us go ahead and check it out that how these rates are being calculated, how SSC is being taxed on the basis of these rates. For that purpose, let us assume that the income of an individual SSC is 3 lakh rupees. This income is net taxable income. The net taxable income is 3 lakh rupees. In that case, we will use the rates which is prescribed in the Income Tax Act. We will first check it out the individual SSC. Thereafter, in the individual SSC, we check it out the age of the SSC. Suppose the age of SSC is below 60 years. In this case, how we will calculate? So first, we will make a similar chart and we check it out. The income from 0 to 2,50,000 is taxed at the rate of nil percentage and is tax payable will be nil. The income of SSC is over 2,50,000, that is 3 lakh. So from 2,50,000 to 3 lakh rupees of SSC's income, the tax rate is 10%, and the income is 50,000 in between these two. That is why the tax payable is 10% of 50,000, that is 5,000. 50,000 into 10%. So the total tax will be calculated by this way. The total is 5,000. This is the tax payable in the easy way, and then thereafter we will provide the SSC the rebate under section 87A. This rebate is allowed for each and every SSC who will be having income less than 5 lakh rupees, that is 2000 rupees rebate. Now the tax of an SSC is 3000 rupees, and on this 3000 rupees we will have to add the cess 1% plus 2%, total 3% cess, that will be the education cess, and higher education cess 2% plus 1%. So 3% of 3000 will be 90. So the tax payable of the assessee who has earned 3 lakh rupees in the previous year is 3,090 rupees. In case the assessee has more income, then the tax will be calculated on the same chart or by the same way. Now, not only that, when we calculate the income of the assessee, we should also remember the two important points that the net taxable income of an assessee is always in the multiplier of 10, and if the tax payable is in the fraction, it will be converted into the rupees 1, and which will be by adding some value, not by subtracting the value. So with this example, we have learned that if the assessee has got 3 lakh rupees income, the tax will be 3090. Now let us take another example where the income of an assessee is more. So I will take another example where net taxable income of the assessee is say 6 lakh rupees. If the net taxable income of an assessee is 6 lakh rupees, then all the slabs which is up to 20% will be applicable on the assessee, and we will calculate the tax by the same way. Income from 0 to 2,50,000 rupees is tax rate is nil, and the amount of tax will also be nil. Further, from 2,50,000 rupees to 3,00,000 rupees, the rate of tax is 10%, here it was 0%, it is 2,50,000 to 5,00,000, the rate of tax is 10%, so in between 2,50,000 is the value, tax at the rate of 10% means 25,000 is payable. Assessee has earned 6,00,000 rupees, which is more than 5,00,000, so we calculate from 5,00,000 rupees, since the total income is 6,00,000, so 5,00,000 to 6,00,000, the value in between is 1,00,000, and it is taxed at the rate of 20%, so 20,000 will be the tax. Now we calculate the tax which is to be paid, total 45,000. Here we need to again check it out that because the assessee's net taxable income is 6 lakh rupees above the 5 lakh, this assessee will not get the benefit of section 87A. Plus, since the income of that assessee is below 1 crore rupees, that is why the surcharge will also not be applicable on this assessee. So, on this tax, we will add only one thing for calculation of tax payable, that will be cess at the rate of 3%, including education and higher education cess. So 45,000 into 3%. And the tax payable is 46,350 rupees. So this will be the total tax payable by the assessee on the income of rupees 6 lakh. But in case the income of assessee increase and it will go more than this, and in the third example, I am expecting that the income of net taxable income of an assessee is 11 lakh rupees. So with this example, we will check it out that if the assessee falls in between the first slab, second slab, or above 10 lakh slab, then how we calculate the tax on the income. So again, we will use the same method, and we start with 0 to 2,50,000. The rate of tax will be nil percentage, and tax payable is nil. Thereafter, from 2,50,000 to 5,00,000, the tax rate is 10%. So in between this, the range is 2,50,000, 5,00,000 minus 250, and on that 2,50,000, 10% tax is payable, so 25,000 is payable. Next slab of assessee was 5,00,000 above to 10,00,000, And 20% was the rate of tax which is applicable on that. So this range include 10 lakh minus 5 lakh means 5 lakh, and tax is payable at the rate of 20%. So 5 lakh into 20%, that will be 1 lakh. Going ahead, since the SSC is having income more than 10 lakh, so the last one will be 10 lakh to 11 lakh, and the rate of tax is 30%. So this stands for 11 lakh minus 10 lakh means 1 lakh at the rate of 30%, so 30,000. Now this, the total income tax which is calculated by these three rates will be 1,55,000. Out of this 1,55,000, the cess will be applicable at the rate of 3%, which includes again the education and higher education cess. So that cess will be calculated on the basis of the 3% calculation. 1,55,000 into 3%, which stands for 4,650, and the total tax which is payable by this SSC will be 1,59,650 rupees. So today we have learned, with the help of these three examples, that how we calculate the tax on the individual SSC. Out of these three examples, I have taken the example of the person who is having the age in between 0 to 60 years. Later on, we will be checking it out, the tax calculation on senior citizen, super senior citizen, tax on the income of partnership firm, limited liability firm, local authority, then the companies. So that's it for all. Thank you.